We are here in beautiful Kealakekua, and I am with Joy Holland, the executive director of the Kona Historical Society. Hello, Joy.
Aloha.
So tell us about this place.
So we're standing here on a ranching homestead from the 1800s, where one of our two national and state registered historic landmarks is located. We're right in front of the H.M. Greenwell General Store. So this was kind of the commercial hub of the area back in the day. And when Hawaii was the crossroads of the Pacific, this was a commercial hub. So what we do here is we try to tell the stories of the region in an authentic way, so people are immersed in time. They can come into these sites and see what life was like during that era. And this is just one of the sites that we steward. So we have another one that's located about a mile away from us here in Kealakekua. It's the Kona Coffee Living History Farm. And that is a historic coffee farm from the early 1900s. And guests can come and sort of be immersed in that time period. They can interact with costumed interpreters and sort of feel what life was like during that era.
That sounds really fun, to be able to talk to people in costume and yeah, learn about the history of Hawaii.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's important to us that we give a clear-eyed view of what everybody's role was in building up Hawaii to be the place that it is. So both of our sites have these historic elements, and both of our sites are very much trying to tell the story of all the ethnicities and all the people that were really involved in making Hawaii the place that it is today. So this is the same site where we also have our Portuguese stone bread oven. Hopefully you'll get a peek at that, but we bake 100 loaves of bread every week in this traditional oven.
Wow, and people can actually come and participate.
Yes, absolutely. We encourage them to come on Thursdays. The program runs from 10 in the morning. They can actually help us roll out the dough and see it go into the oven. And later on, about 1 o'clock, they can buy the fresh hot bread.
Wow. Now, what's on the horizon for the Kona Historical Society?
So we're very excited. Part of our original mission, when we started as a small group of historically minded citizens that wanted to share Kona's history. And we've done that over the years, but we haven't had a traditional venue where we can actually have rotating exhibits and share some of the photos and the history that we steward here in our archive and library. So we're actually building a small solar panel powered little gallery structure, and it's going to be looking like the rest of this site, a traditional ranch building with a high-pitched roof, and people will be able to come, visitors and residents, and see our history and see it change from time to time, so that we're telling all the stories of the area.
Wow, sounds exciting.
Yeah, we're really excited about it.
Well, thank you so much, Joy. You mentioned the communal oven.
Yes.
Well, coming up on Living 808, I am going to make some Portuguese bread the old-fashioned way. Stay tuned.